Now, friends, this is a very rugged portion of Scripture, yet it can minister to our hearts, and especially this is a good section for politicians. It's a good section for the rulers of a nation, and it's good for a nation. Now, we are following both kingdoms of Israel and Judah. In the north, 10 tribes constitute the northern kingdom of Israel, and in the south, Judah constitutes the main part with Benjamin. And that's where the line of David is reigning. And that's the line that, of course, that will be followed right on into the New Testament to the birth of the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, last time we saw that line was almost eliminated by Athaliah, a daughter of Jezebel and Ahab, who had married into the family of David. But there was one little fella that a nurse had hidden away, and she kept him there till he was 7, and Jehoiada the high priest brought him out to the people, having got the protection of the captains and the leaders of the nation. And he reigned until he was 47 years old, and then he was murdered by his own servants. You see, this is a bloody period. It's not a pretty period at all. And yet, during the reign of Joash, it was a period of revival. In fact, the first revival that these people had. And it came at a most unlikely time. And that's the reason that I believe that we can have revival in our day. And we're going to see it later on in this same book, by the way, because there were actually 5 revival periods, and we'll put a great emphasis on this when we get to the 2 books of Chronicles. Now we find here at chapter 13, as we come here, Jehoahaz, the son of Jehu, he reigns over Israel for 17 years, and he follows in the sinful steps of Jeroboam. Actually, there's nothing very sensational or interesting in his reign at all. So many people feel that sin and that type of thing brings excitement into a life. May I say, there's nothing quite as boring as sin after a while. The man who starts drinking reaches the day when he's a drunkard. And when he becomes a drunkard, he is as boring as anyone can possibly be, and life loses its purpose. The same thing is true of any individual that indulges in sin. This is a period when there's really not much excitement going on. The excitement goes on when God is moving, friends, and how we need Him today on the scene.